Hi everyone, thanks to Aqara, my bathroom just got a whole lot smarter. This is a project I've been working on for a while, so I'm excited to finally share it with you to give you some ideas of what's possible. If you don't already know, Aqara makes quality smart home products that can be purchased on a budget, which is perfect for what I'm doing today. This video will be a little bit longer, but as always, I've included chapters, so feel free to skip around, or even better, watch from the beginning to end. Okay, let's get started. First, thank you to Aqara for totally hooking me up for today's video. I asked them for a lot of products to make this video and they were so generous to help me out. When I decided to make my bathroom smart, Aqara was a great choice since they offer so many sensors and devices that work well with each other. Aqara communicates using Zigbee, making their devices both fast and reliable, all without strain on my Wi-Fi network. And perhaps best of all, they're more affordable than many of the other HomeKit compatible brands on the market. Aqara devices do require a hub, but don't let that stop you because even with the added expense of a hub, you're still saving money. If you just need something basic that works well and is small, then the E1 USB hub is only $39.99 Canadian. But if you want to control your remote control devices and make them smart as well, maybe a fan, fireplace, or TV, well, Aqara has you covered with their M2 and G3 hub. If you want a hub that can trigger an alarm when there's unintended motion or a door window opens, well, for that there's the M1S hub which comes equipped with a light as well as a loudspeaker. Or maybe you want an indoor camera. Well, Aqara has a solution for you there as well with their G2H and G3 camera hubs. I'll link an Aqara playlist in the description that includes some videos that I've done reviewing their hubs as well as various other accessories. All of the devices I've used in my bathroom have been paired to the E1 hub, which is perfect because it's placed in our hallway right outside our bathroom. So even though these hubs generally have great range, I know I'll be able to maintain a solid connection. Here are the products that I'm using in my smart bathroom. Now do keep in mind that you don't have to go to the extent that I have, but hopefully this will give you some ideas and get you thinking of what would be useful for you. Here's what I want to accomplish. I want the lights to turn on automatically when someone enters the room. There's no window in this room, so I want to make sure that the lights are bright during the day, dimmer in the evening, and then even lower at night. I also want to make sure the lights don't stay on too long after someone exits, while making sure not to turn the lights off if someone's in the shower, since motion will be difficult to detect. I'm in a newer, airtight home, and as mentioned, there's no window in this room, so ventilation is important. I want to make it easy for someone to turn on the fan when having a bath or shower and have it stay on for 1 hour. I also want to ensure that if someone forgets to turn it on, the fan will turn on automatically when the humidity gets too high and turn off after 1 hour. I also want to make sure that the fan turns on when someone is, well, you know, funky. But only for 15 minutes, so I'm not wasting energy. Leaks can cost hundreds or even thousands of dollars in damage from a leaking washing machine, a broken pipe, or an overflowing bathtub. I want to make sure that if there is a leak, I'm alerted right away so I can take action. My daughter uses this hair straightener and I want to make sure that she doesn't accidentally leave it on, which could waste energy and even be a potential fire hazard. Okay, let's start with lighting. I'm using the double rocker wall switch with a neutral wire. Aqara does make a non-neutral wire version as well, which is really nice because those are harder to find. But it is recommended that you use the neutral wire version if your wiring is compatible. Most modern homes will have a neutral wire, which is the white wire that brings current back to the electrical panel. The advantage of the neutral wire switch is that you get power monitoring and it works as a repeater to strengthen the range of your Zigbee mesh network. Additionally, it enables you to add even more child devices to many of your car hubs, like the E1 hub that I'm using today, that's capable of up to 128 child devices with the addition of repeaters like the switch I'm installing. Most homes built after the 1980s will have a neutral wire, which is usually identified by a grouping of white wires capped together. If you're not sure you're not comfortable with wiring, then it's advisable to hire an electrician to do the work for you. For more detailed instructions on installing the switch, I'll link a helpful video in the description. So this is a double rocker. Once installed, the top button will control the power to the switch, turning it on or off, and the bottom button can then be programmed for other uses like controlling a fan or setting a HomeKit scene. I'll let you know how I have this set up shortly. The switch works great, but the downside is that it's not dimmable. I really hope to see Aqara offer dimmable switches in the future. But even if these lights were dimmable, I want to be able to adjust the lighting temperature from cool during the day to warm at night. That's why I purchased these Nanoleaf Essentials A19 light bulbs. These lights are capable of changing color as well as lighting temperature. They communicate using thread, so it's important that you have a thread border router like a HomePod Mini or a 2021 Apple TV 4K. Otherwise, they'll instead communicate using Bluetooth and you're probably gonna have issues. Aqara does offer an A19 light bulb that's capable of dimming and adjusting lighting temperature, but unfortunately, it's not available in North America. Depending on where you are, you may be lucky enough to incorporate these lights into your smart home. I typically don't recommend mixing smart lights with smart switches because often they don't play nicely together. But I've tested the Nanoleaf bulbs with the Aqara wall switch before purchasing from my bathroom to make sure that they work fine. The kids will mostly use white, however, I wouldn't put it past them to use party lights when having a bath or shower. Aqara has an option in their app to disable the physical light switch, allowing full control by their wireless mini switch. This basically keeps the power to the device on, which is crucial if you're using smart lights, because if the switch is powered off, the lights won't work. Worth noting is that the physical light switch can still be turned off in either the Aqara or the Home app, so just make sure to leave it powered on. The top button is permanently on and disabled for any other use. The bottom button I'm using as an off switch. Although I'll program the lights to eventually turn off automatically, I still want to have manual controls. Since pressing the bottom button triggers an on or off state, I had to program the lights to turn off when the switch is turned on, as well as off, which I programmed in the Home app. To trigger these lights to turn on, I'm using the Aqara motion sensor. Since I need this motion sensor to control my Nanoleaf lights, this can't simply be done in the Aqara app. I also need to specify some conditions, so I'm doing this in the HomePlus 5 app. If you don't have HomePlus 5, you can also use the Eve app. It's a free app and it allows for conditional automations, the same as HomePlus 5. One thing I like about HomePlus 5 is the ability to create folders to keep your automations organized. I created 4 separate automations. Between 7:30 a.m. and 9 p.m., my lights will come on at 100% brightness. Between 9 p.m. and 11 p.m., my lights will come on at 25% brightness. Time-based trigger automations that cross over midnight, such as between sunrise and sunset, tend to be problematic. So to adjust for this, I've split my night automation into 2, which solves that problem. Between 11 and 11:59, my vanity lights will turn to just 5% brightness. Then between 12 a.m. and 7:30 a.m., my vanity lights again turn on to 5% brightness. Technically, this leaves a 1 minute gap between 11:59 and 12 where the lights won't automatically turn on, but it's pretty low risk, and don't worry because I have a solution for this as well that I'll discuss later. I've also separated the lights between overhead and vanity to provide even more flexibility, such as only turning on the vanity lights at night. I only want the lights to turn on if they were already off. This means if you manually adjust the lights, either brighter or dimmer, they won't automatically change back when motion is detected, which would be really annoying. This is essential for any light automation being controlled by a motion sensor. Although I have the overhead and vanity lights grouped together, HomePlus 5 requires a condition based on a specific accessory, which is why you see the trigger is based specifically on my middle vanity light. To program the lights turning off, I'm using the Aqara app. I have an automation that says if there's been no motion in over 5 minutes and the door is open, then turn the lights off. You can see it listed as turn on, off, off. That may look a little confusing, but it just means that it will turn the bottom button named off, on, or off depending on its current state. I also have a condition when the door is open. So why? Having an automation to turn the lights off automatically after 5 minutes without motion is great, but what if someone is having a shower? Well, luckily, there's an easy way to account for this by using a door and window sensor. If you're someone that leaves the door open when you shower, then you could consider a door window sensor on the shower door. I have a shower curtain, so it would be challenging to maintain a solid closed reading, but you could also try to accomplish this by adding a second motion sensor in the shower. So there's a few different options that you could explore. To show you how this works, when I go into my bathroom, the lights are going to turn on automatically and they'll turn off in 5 minutes. This time I'm going to turn the lights on, but I'm going to shut the door. And I'll show you that they'll stay on longer than 5 minutes. So it's been about 7.5 minutes here. And if I check the Home app, I can see that the lights are still on. As long as this door is closed, the lights are not going to turn off. If I open the door, now the timer's gonna reset and they're gonna stay on for another 5 minutes as long as no motion is detected. Another bonus of using the Nanoleaf Essentials bulbs is that they're compatible with adaptive lighting, meaning depending on the time of day, the lights will come on at the right lighting temperature. Some more yellow light in the evening and at night, and brighter bluish white light in the day. So I've had this set up for a while and it's worked out well. But what about those times where you need to physically turn the lights on? Remember, we've disabled the physical light switch. We also have that 60-second gap between 11:59 and midnight. Or let's say someone walks out of the bathroom, turns the lights off, then seconds later, someone walks back in. Motion is detected in 1-minute increments, so the motion sensor won't automatically trigger right away. Or maybe it's the evening and the lights turned on at 25% brightness, but you want the lights to be at 100%. You could, of course, pull out your iPhone or Apple Watch, maybe holler at Siri if you have a HomePod nearby, but that's not necessarily quick or convenient. That's where the first of the 3 wireless mini switches comes in. Here I place the button right below the motion sensor. These can be programmed in any way that you want. These buttons are awesome for adding physical controls in convenient locations. I programmed my wireless mini switch like this. A single press turns my lights on to 100%, a double press turns the lights on at 50%, and a long press is 25%. If I was simply controlling the Aqara wall switch, I could just use the Aqara app. However, since these are Nanoleaf bulbs, I've had to program this in the Home app. So that's pretty much it for smart lighting. This can be customized in any way that you wish. This is just an example. If you don't care about adjusting the brightness or color temperature, then you could simply use standard light bulbs. If pairing with the Aqara M1 or M1S hub, then you could also use the night light, which could provide the right amount of light in the middle of the night. Just keep in mind that those hubs tend to take up the full wall outlet, so you may want to use an outlet extender so you have room for things like a hairdryer. I also want to mention that while I've used automations for my lighting, you could also try creating a Siri shortcut. Shortcuts generally take more effort to set up, but can be easier to maintain. Personally, I find it challenging to create a reliable shortcut when adding several conditions, but could be an option to explore. If you have any lighting shortcuts, then I encourage you to share how you've done it in the comments to give us all new ideas. Okay, onto the exhaust fan. Controlling humidity levels is important as excessive moisture can lead to wood rot and structural damage as it softens drywall. Where I live, and I would imagine most parts of the world, it's code to have an exhaust fan. To turn on the fan, all you need to do is press the switch, which I'm using a single rocker wall switch with a neutral wire. Pressing the switch turns it on, and I have it automatically turn off after 1 hour, which is enough time to shower and then provide enough time afterwards to properly ventilate. This type of automation can be set up in the Aqara app by saying, if the fan turns on, then wait 59 minutes and 59 seconds, and then turn it off. The max delay is 59 minutes and 59 seconds, which is why it's not exactly 1 hour. But if you're like me, you forget to turn on the fan until you're in the shower. So instead of hollering at Siri and hoping she hears you, I've installed my second wireless mini switch right in the shower. This shower is acrylic, so it sticks easily, and I positioned it on the far side of the shower to avoid excessive moisture. It's out of the way, yet convenient to control when in the shower. A single press turns the fan on, and it will turn off automatically after 1 hour. This is really all I need to do, but since I have multiple presses, I've used the double press to turn the lights to 100%, just in case more lights ever needed. And a long press turns the lights purple, because why not? These actions were all set up in the Home app. Adding the wireless mini switch should really help to make it easy to turn on the exhaust fan, but my kids are usually the ones using the shower and they're not the best at remembering. That's why I also use this temperature and humidity sensor. The sensor is small and it's easy to place anywhere that you need it. There's no screen, but you can check both temperature and humidity from the Aqara app or even the Home app. But using the Aqara app lets you view historical information. I find it helpful to be able to monitor air quality metrics throughout my home since air quality can be different throughout the house. I want to create an automation that automatically turns the fan on once humidity is above 60%. Where I live in Ontario, Canada, humidity can fluctuate a lot, from really humid summers to dry winters. I set it to 60% since even in the summer with our AC running, humidity levels shouldn't get above that level. As a test, I used the shower purposefully without using the fan. You can see here the spike of humidity which reached nearly 80%. I only did this for about 5 minutes before turning the fan back on. This automation is done in the Aqara app. I have if humidity is above 59%, then turn the fan on, wait 59 minutes and 59 seconds, then turn the fan off. You could also automate the fan to turn it back off at a specified humidity level if you prefer, instead of setting a time frame like I did. You can also use the Aqara TVOC monitor here as well. It would allow for the same humidity automation, but it comes with a screen and it also monitors total volatile organic compounds in the air. So say you're cleaning and your air quality drops. You could have your fan come on automatically to help exhaust the air. The last of my wireless mini switches is going here. I don't think I need to explain this one too much, but let's just say humidity isn't the only time you need an exhaust fan in the bathroom. If you find some emoji stickers, then you can do what I've done to my flick button in my ensuite bathroom, just so there's no confusion what this button is for. My ensuite's a little bit more complicated because I have this flick button controlling a smart switch, which starts a timer, then turns the fan off. Aqara makes this so much easier, no proxy plug needed here. I set it up like this. A single press turns the fan on for 15 minutes, a double press turns it on for 20 minutes, and a long press turns the lights to 100%. This one probably isn't necessary, but it never hurts to add additional lighting controls in convenient locations. If you had a HomePod mini in here, then you could use the long press to play some cool tunes. Okay, on to the water leak sensor. Nobody likes to spend money on a water leak sensor, but it's like insurance. You hate paying for it, but when you need it, you're sure glad that you had it. Being on the second level, I wouldn't even want to estimate how much damage could be caused if there was a major leak. And while the water leak sensor won't prevent leaks, it will alert you to take immediate action. That could be running upstairs, or if you're away from home, calling a neighbor to check in on your home. Like all Aqara products, the water leak sensors are inexpensive, making it easy to place throughout your home. Laundry rooms, water tanks, dishwashers, really just anywhere there's plumbing could be useful. I like that these are battery operated as well, since there isn't always an outlet nearby. Aqara says the battery can last over 2 years based on normal use, which hopefully isn't a lot. I'm placing one under the sink and another one by the toilet. I don't have one specifically for the bathtub, but it's close enough to the one by the toilet that it would be triggered quickly. Shortly after we moved here, we actually had a small leak thanks to the kids overfilling the bathtub. Luckily, we caught it right away and no damage was done, but it was large enough of a leak that water dripped through the pot light in our kitchen, so it could have been bad if we weren't at home or if it wasn't caught right away. The Aqara water leak sensor will give you peace of mind and help protect the value of your home. Lastly, I'm making my daughter's hair straightener smart by using Aqara's smart plug. There are a lot of smart plugs out there and most of them communicate via Wi-Fi and can be finicky in my experience. Like all Aqara products, their smart plug communicates using Zigbee, so it's fast and reliable. Like the wall switch, the smart plug can be used as a Zigbee repeater, helping to strengthen your Zigbee mesh network and help realize your hub's full potential of up to 128 child devices, like the E1 hub that I'm using. There are a lot of reasons to add smart plugs throughout your home, but for the bathroom, I'll be using this with the timer function to ensure my daughter's hair straightener isn't left turned on. Once the hair straightener is plugged in, the button on the smart plug can be turned on, and I've created an automation in the Aqara app that'll automatically turn it off after 15 minutes. Pretty easy, right? Simple, but effective. You could also use a smart plug in here for a nightlight, or perhaps even an accent light. Okay, wow, that was a lot of information, but I'm so happy that my bathroom is now smart. This setup works great for me, but as I've mentioned, there are many different ways that this could be set up, just depending on your needs and your budget. But using Aqara really makes so much sense because the overall cost is considerably less than with other manufacturers, all while remaining fast and reliable. Of course, you could take this even further by adding a HomePod mini for some shower tunes, maybe an LED light strip along the mirror. Let me know what smart bathroom accessories you use. I'd be curious to know, and I think everyone could benefit from your suggestions, so let me know in the comments. Once again, thanks to Aqara for making my smart bathroom happen. I hope this was useful and you've come away with a few ideas. I'll have links to all of these products in the description. Thanks as always for watching, and I'll talk to you soon.